3 common biodigester toilet problems and how to avoid them. Hi, thank you once again for joining me here on Dreamhouse Biodigesters. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about the 3 most common biodigester toilet problems and how to avoid them. On this channel, we do videos that give you the reason why in the near future you might have to consider installing a biodigester. We also do other videos, tutorial videos, for those who are learning how to install a biodigester and the step-by-step guide that they might need for their project. Our website, dreamhousebiodigester.com, is active. You can go there and see the type of biodigesters that we have for homeowners. We also have some few articles we have written. You can take your time and read some of them. We are on Instagram, we are on Facebook at Dreamhouse Biodigesters. My name is Jerry Adu-Asare. Despite all the advantages associated with biodigesters, which we have spoken about extensively in some of our videos, there are certain misconceptions and misunderstandings on how this biodegradable, eco-friendly toilet actually works. I do know of a couple who have done a biodigester and are now contemplating on going back to constructing a traditional septic system. Their anger, their frustration is that the technology is not solving the problem they were thinking it was going to solve. The issue is every technology in this world that has come up has got its problems. Biodigesters are no exception. There are some certain problems that you will encounter and you face when you install them. And in this video, I'm going to reveal them to you and show you how to avoid them. Stay with us. This is Dreamhouse Biodigesters. Doing this video from a house, a client who has given us a project and we are working on it. I'll take you around later to have a look at what is exactly that we are doing. Let's go into the video now.
Here are the 3 most common issues that affect biodigesters and how to solve them. Problem 1. Excess water in the biodigester. Because biodigester waste management system biodegrade waste materials for easy disposal, excess water means that solid waste don't get the chance to be separated for microorganisms to break them down. Another problem is, if that happens, it becomes difficult to flush the water closer to units since there is excess water in the pipeway. 2 things can lead to this. Actually, 3 things can lead to this. Excessive flushing, non-biodegradable materials clogging the digester, and constructing a digester in a waterlogged area. To solve this problem, minimize the amount of water going into your biodigester, flushing only when it's necessary and not flushing non-biodegradable materials which eventually choke the pipes. Low flow or dual flush toilets will also minimize water going into the system. Also, it's important that before you install a digester, you have the soil test to determine the level of the water table. If it's a waterlogged area, then the plumber must, as a necessity, use a P-trap seat, or the footing of the building must be up enough to allow for the digester to be up so that it doesn't get filled up too quickly. Flushing non-biodegradable items. Non-biodegradable products in the biodigester fill up space and will never break down naturally. They also create problems for the microorganisms that are supposed to break down human waste. This includes items like diapers, paper towels, and even cigarette butts. Even so-called flushable products don't break down as they should sometimes. When you use a baby wipe to clean up your little one and change their diaper, be sure to wrap up and dispose of both items in a trash can. Wrap them in toilet paper and throw them out instead of flushing them down the toilet. Both items can clog the toilet rather easily. Because toilet papers are sensitive appliances with plumbing that's created to flush just a few septic items, it is important to only flush bodily waste and toilet tissue, nothing else. Simply put, keep all non-biodegradable products out of the digester.
So we are doing a biodigester. So we are doing the large family size biodigester for this property. I want to take you around to see the progress of work and then give you some few commentaries on what is it that we are doing. Let's go. The digester is going to be here. The biodigester will be here. We have that gate. We are just waiting to lay the blocks and of course do the inside toppings and bed. The digester bed. So this is the family size large digester. It's going to be 6 feet by four. The depth will be 4 feet. And then there's going to be the soak hole here where the filtration and the treatment is going to happen. The leche pipe will pass through this place and connect the digester to the soak hole, which will be filled with rocks and other filtration materials. This is the soak away that we have dug for the kitchen, bathhouse, and then the laundry room water, the wastewater that will come from there. This is the waste that we are doing for it, the soak away actually. It's going to be 6 feet, the depth is 6 feet, 5 feet breadth, and length is going to be 6 feet as well. Query that block, that's key for this type of soak aways. You can't go wrong with a query that block when you're doing a soak away. We've also done the top slabs, it's been cast and it's ready for them to put on it after the plumber has done the connections from this, from the kitchen and the bathroom and of course the laundry room.
3. Using too much detergent. As much as this is not a problem with the newly designed biodigesters, too much detergent, which usually have phosphates, acts as fertilizer, encouraging algae growth that can block your perforations in your distribution pipes. Overuse of these products, and more importantly, the wrong product, will be a problem for your pipes and biodigester tank. Use liquid or gel soap or any non-harsh detergents in washing your toilet bowls. Moreover, harsh products will kill off the bacteria in your tank that are necessary to break down waste in the biodigester. There are certain commercial products that claim to clear clogged pipes but often contain toxic or hazardous chemicals that are bad for the environment.
Thank you for watching this video. This is Dreamhouse Biodigesters. If you are new to this channel, we will ask you to consider subscribing. We have the several simple steps on how to install a biodigester. We also have the 11 facts about biodigesters that you need to know.